we learn regarding the definitions of electrocardiogram. This is nothing but this is an instrument or graph, so that was record the electrical activities in our body. So these are the this is a myocardium, and from the myocardium, so they are transmigrated to the our body, so they are recorded. So with the help of the various electrodes, so among them, so this ECG, it consists of mainly these waves, that is P, Q, R, S, T. So already you know regarding the P waves, it is atrial depolarization, and Q, R, S, ventricular depolarization, and T wave, that is ventricular repolarization. And you have in a confusion, sir, are you forgetting whether it is there is no atrial repolarization, that is the relaxations of atria, because only here it is indicates atrial contraction or what atrial function, that depolarization we learn with the help of P waves. Okay, then QRS complex represents ventricular depolarizations or ventricular contraction, and T wave represents ventricular repolarization, that is the ventricular relaxations. But what about the atrial repolarizations or atrial relaxation? So dear students, so atrial repolarization, it can merge with the QRS complex. The period of atrial relaxations or atrial repolarization, so that was merged in QRS complex, or the duration is same as related to the QRS complex. So that's why the atrial repolarization is not recorded by the machine due to merge with the ventricular depolarizations or QRS complex. Okay, so next one, regarding the lead, it consists of lead 1, lead 2, lead 3. So these are main lead, then AVR, AVL and AVF. So but commonly used lead is a lead 2, but it is a serious condition. The doctors, so they are using the all the lead, lead 1, lead 2, lead 3, lead AVR, AVL, AVF, then along with V1, V2, V3, V4. So like that, so all the 12 leads, so they are leads, they are used and record the electrical impulses, activities, how they are transported from right to the left or left to the right, upper to the down. So like that, with the help of the different lead, so they are monitor the electrical activities. So with the help of that only, they can note down where is the problems. So why that candidate was suffering from the cardiac insufficiency or cardiac functions or malfunction. So with the help of ECG, so they can note down the various conditions they are occurs or abnormal condition. So they are occurs or in the myocardium or in the heart. So that's why the ECG is the main instrument. It is helpful for to know the scenario in the myocardium or scenario in the cardiac muscle. And also it is helpful for to know the how the atria, ventricles or wall, they are work. Or also what is the concentrations of regarding electrolytes or nutrition, how they are reflected, whether they are abnormal in there, they are whether they are high concentration in there, whether they are low concentration in there, that is also you can conclude their effect on the myocardium or cardiac muscles with the help of the ECG. Okay, so this is the placing of lead. Okay, so main 4 lead, that is the electrode, so they are placed in the both arm and as well as both leg. Okay, and remaining chest leads, so they place in the between 4th and 5th intercostal space. That is intercostal space, nothing but between 4th and 5th ribs, because already you know the exact positions of heart is between 3rd and 5th ribs. So already you will learn in the anatomy regarding the place of the heart. The heart is placed in the left hand side. One small part that was present in the right hand side, but maximum about 90% the place of the heart is a left side. And exact position is it is present between the third and seventh ribs. So that's why the doctors, so they are targeted, that is the fourth and fifth intercostal space between ribs, that is the exact locations of the heart. So when the electrical impulses are conducted, same can conduct in the these muscles, that is the intercostal muscle. Then these lead are led, so they are helpful for to monitor the electrical activity. So due to that, we can know down what is the position, so where there is the abnormal or normal, any other there. So with the help of the different lead systems of the ECG. So then this is a typical ECG graph paper. Okay. So it consists of large square and as well as small square. So large square, it consists of 4 by 4, 16 small square. And regarding the calculations for one small square, if the height is crosses one small square, means that volt is 0.1 millivolt. If it is traveling, crossing one small square, means the time is 0.04 second. So this is the basic. You should be remember this one. Okay, later on, normal values of P, Q, R, S, T, then only you are able to conclude whether it is normal or abnormal. Easily, that calculation should be remembered in your mind. Okay, so not you seen every time in the notebooks. Okay, you should be keep in reminder in your minds. Okay, as a stored. That is a one small square denotes, that is 1.1 millivolt and 0.04 second. Okay, then after that, the normal value of P. So that was, in future, with the help of ECG, you can conclude what will be the happens with the patients, whether he is normal or whether he is having any problem. If problem is there, then according to that only you can open your brain regarding the drugs, regarding the therapy, regarding the advice. Those only advice you can give. Otherwise, if you are failure to detect, okay, so that ECG, so then you are giving the wrong counselings. Okay, so negative counselings, it can reflect on your negative careers. Okay, so that's why. So you always remember, initially you can see the chart in the books, in mobiles, but later on, as the practice is going on, without your mobiles, without your book notes, you can read the ECG. Okay, that was boost your knowledge to exactly to know the risk factor for that condition, and according to that only you can counsel the patients. Okay, so next we are learn regarding the P waves. So it only take 2 millivolt, that is 0.2 millivolt, any it can crosses the height, only 2 small square, and travel, that is 0.1 second, it means it can travel 2.5 small square, and 1 small square is 1 mm. Okay, so then these significance. If it is more than 2.5, that indicates right atrial hypertrophy. Okay, that is the swelling of the right atrium. If the right atrium swelling means, so there may be microbial infection is there, because deagglutinated blood, so that was first time in the heart, it was deposited in the right atrium. If it is hypertrophy means, so there is no that much pressure was created. Already you know the pressure of the right atrium, that is around 4 to 6, okay, mmSg. If it is hypertrophy means, so that pressure may be increases because there is need to powerful contraction due to swelling, due to hypertrophy. Hypertrophy nothing but enlargement or swelling due to excess accumulations of fluid is there, or any problem in the muscles. Okay, then it required more pressure to contract, then automatically your blood pressure is increases. That was monitored. So with the help of the, so this traveling, if it is crosses more than 2.5 means, so there is a right atrial hypertrophy. If the P wave is M shaped means left atrial hypertrophy. It is also important how the blood can reaches to the atrium, okay, from the lungs. That is regarding oxygenated blood from the lung, it was deposited in the right left atrium. If any problem in the pulmonary veins, that was known as the pulmonary embolisms or pulmonary hypertension due to occlusion in the pulmonary vein, okay, so the blood cannot that much reaches to the left atrium, or due to any problem in the lungs, then the left atria is also suffering from the hypertrophy. Okay, so on that time, the P waves, it is look like a M shaped. Okay, so with the help of, you should be note down the scenario conditions of the left atrium. If it is normal, there is no problem. If it is M shaped, it indicates some problem in the left atrium. That according to that only, you can choose the medications. Okay, because for hypertrophy, the medications are different. For hypertension, the medications are different. Both medication, they can decrease the elevated blood pressure. But all medication, they do not treat the hypertrophy, swelling or enlargement of the heart or ventricles or atrium. Only targeted drugs are there, so they can control the hypertrophy, then control the blood pressure. So like that, with the help of ECG, it was helpful to you to choose the which type of drug you should be administered to the patient to enhance the life of the patient and to decrease the incidence of the risk factor. If it is small and spaceless, safeless, it indicates atrial extrasystole. Then absent, it indicates hyperkalemia or SA node block. Okay, hyperkalemia means the potassium level in the blood, whatever the blood is circulated in the myocardium through a coronary circulation, that is consist of the rich of potassium. So where you can take the precautions to avoid the excess of intake of potassium to that patients in the food or in the daily life. So then they were helpful for to manage the cardiovascular disorder. So that P views, it can signify that was abnormalities, pathological and physiological variations related to the atria or atrium chambers. Okay, so that is with the help of that PVOs, we can be signifies. So what is the problem in the both atrium? So next one is the QRS complex. So already you know the QRS complex represents or recorded on the ECG. So when the ventricles are depolarized, okay, the ventricles, so when they are depolarized, then only the QRS complex was recorded. And here, dear students, the depolarizations mean the accumulations of sodium. Okay, so how the sodium is accumulated means, so due to opening of sodium channel. So sodium channels will be open when they got the stimuli. Okay, when they got the stimuli are impulses in the form of action potential. So here is the ventricle. So that stimuli, so that action potential, so they can came from the atrium, that is the AV node, towards the AV bundle, Purkinje fiber and branches. Okay, so then traveling from AV node to AV bundle to Purkinje fiber and left and right branches. Okay, so on that time, how the waves are action potential traveled, like that only the QRS complex was recorded. Okay, it denotes ventricles are start to depolarize or start to contract. Okay, and so regarding the QRS complex, it consists of three waves, that is Q, R and S. The Q is, it can show the negative deflections. Okay, it can move downwards, not a positive, not a upward. Okay, then amplitude of Q is 0.1 to 0.2. It means that is 0.1 millivolt is equal to 1 small square. So here the Q amplitude is 0.1 to 0.2 millivolt, and Q is a negative reflections or negative deflections. Okay, they can record it downward. It means the after the P waves, the Q waves can recorded in the downward about only 2 small square. Okay, only it can negative deflection shows about only 1 to two small square. That is a normal recording of the Q waves. So after that, the R waves are recorded. The amplitude of R waves is a point, that is a 1 millivolt. It means one small square is equal to 0.1. And here 1 millivolt means that is the 10 small square. Okay, it can move up to 10 small square. Okay, then S wave, it is also, it can show the negative deflection or reflection, or it can recorded downwards. And amplitude is, that is the 0.4 millivolt, it means it can crosses the, that is the 4 small square here. It is the straight line. In the below, it can travel about 4 small square, that is a normal S view. And regarding Q views, it can travel below the recorded, that is 0.1 to 2 means 1 to 2 small square. And regarding R view, it is a positive reflections. It can recorded in the upward, okay. It is the taken, that the amplitude is 1 millivolt, it means it can crosses the 10 small square, that is the normal. And duration and traveling, that was 0.08 to 0.1 second. Okay, 1 small square is equal to 0.04 second. And here the normal duration of QRS complex is recorded is 0.08 to 0.1 second. It means it can travel only, there is a 2 to 2.5 small square. Because time is 0.08 to 0.1 second and one small square traveling is 0.04 second. That's why within three small square, 2.5 small square, both QRS waves are recorded, are traveled. But regarding amplitude height, the R wave height is 10 small square. And Q downward is only 1 to 2 and S, that is 4 small square. But distance traveled is only 2 to 2.5 small square. That is the normal ratio of the QRS complex. Okay. Then with the help of QRS, we can know down the scenario of the ventricles functions. Okay. So that is the first one is, if it is prolonged, okay, regarding the time duration, instead of 2.5 small square, it can travel more than 2.5. Or the height, instead of 10 small square, it can take more than 10. Okay, then on that time also, it can take the more time. So that was where it is prolonged. So that indicates bundle branch can be blocked. Okay, so due to bundle branch block, so that can reach to septum, it can take the longer time due to blockage in the bundle branch. So due to longer time, the ventricles are take longer time to contract. So due to that, the recorded is more, it can travel more than 2.5 small square, that is the distance. And height, it also travel more than 10 small square regarding the R views. Okay, so that denote some block in the bundle branch or maybe hyperkalemia, that is the high concentrations of the potassium. So that was present in the blood. So that blood was circulated to the myocardium. So now the doctors, are you, if you want to differentiate whether it is a bundle branch block or hyperkalemia, simply after ECG, if you want to differentiate whether it is a bundle branch block or hyperkalemia, so after ECG, if the QRS complex is prolonged, it denotes either block, either hyperkalemia. Still, you want to differentiate means you go through the monitor plasma concentration of the potassium. If in the blood, the potassium level is normal means that denotes the block. If the potassium level is high means, so that denote the hyperkalemia. So like that, you should be differentiate whether it is the blockage in the heart or whether it is a high concentrations of the potassium. So with the help of the ECG. Then according to that only you can choose the medication. For block, different medications are there. For hyperkalemia, other medications are there. So where it is helpful for to choose the correct medication or to signify the what will be happens with the ventricles. Next one, if R wave is look like M, okay, if the R wave, if it is abnormal, actually it is a sharp, okay, it is recorded as a sharp, but if it is M shape or abnormal shape in the pinch, okay, so that indicates left bundle branch block. Okay, here the P waves is corrected sharp. If it is M, okay, here, so that it indicates left bundle branch regarding only R wave. Okay, if the R wave, it is having the M shape in the end, so that denotes left bundle branch will be the block and right will be work very well. Okay, if R wave is double, okay, so one, then as well as immediately there is a second. Okay, if the R wave is double, so that indicates right bundle branch block. Okay, so that indicates right bundle branch block. So that, like that, so with the help of the QRS complex, we can note down the which part will be the block. Okay, so next one, regarding the significance of Q waves, if it is travel more than 1 millimeter or more than 2 millimeter deep, then or more than 25% of depth of the QRS complex, okay, with lead V1 and V3, okay, with the lead V1, V3, when you are recording the ECG with the help of lead, that is lead V1, V3, so where the Q wave complex is more than 25% of the depth, or if it is more than 1 mm or 2 mm deep, that denotes that person was suffering from the MI, that is myocardial infraction. Okay, there is a inflammation, scar in the myocardium related to the ventricles. Due to that, it can take the longer decay, because so any infractions or clot in the myocardium, so that muscle become non-insulator. Actually, myocardium is a insulator. They can transmit the current like our wires. Okay, but due to any scar or inflammation in the myocardium, so that become the non-insulator. If the waves came like but cannot crosses, they can take the longer durations, like that. If it is not a scar, then directly it can enter. Due to scar, infraction or inflammation, it can take the longer duration. Due to that, it can record the longer durations. So that denotes if the Q waves, if it is more than 25% or more than 1 mm deep or 2 mm deep, that indicates myocardial infraction or cardiomyopathies. Myopathies means some disorder or pain. So that is in the problem in the myocardia. So that is denotes the cardiomyopathies or hypertrophic infiltrative myocardial disease. Whether it is a hypertrophic or infiltrative myocardial disease. With the help of Q waves, we can note on the whether it is a myocardial infraction or any inflammation in the myocardium, the cardiomyopathy, or any hypertrophic, okay, that is nothing but accumulations of the more sodium, that was condition, causes that condition was known as hypertrophic or infiltrative myocardial disease. So that was learned or diagnosis with the help of the Q waves. So this is the significance regarding the QRS complex. So next one is the T waves. So T waves denotes ventricular relaxations or ventricular repolarization. So in the ECG, so this is the location recording of the T waves. So it denotes ventricular repolarization or ventricular relaxation. So regarding the amplitude, it will be take 0.3 millivolt. So our calculation is 0.1 millivolt is 1 small square. It means the height of the T wave should be 3 small square. It means the PVOs, it can take only 2 small square because it is a 0.2 millivolt. But the TVOs, it can take the 3 small square, that is 0.3 volt. It is the higher than the PVO, you should be remember. Okay, in the here also you get denoted. The PVO is small as compared to TVOs. Okay, because its amplitude is 0.3, it can cross the 3 small square. And duration is 0.2 second. It means 0.04 second is equal to 1 small square. And 0.08 is equal to 2 small square. And 0.12 is equal to 3 small square. Like that 0.2 second, it can require the 5 small square. So like that. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So here it is recorded like that. Okay. So this is the, and it is the dark. Okay. It can take the height. That is regarding the 3 small square and the travel is the, that is the 5 small square. That is the normal recording of the TVOs. It can denote the relaxations of the ventricles or ventricular filling. Okay, now significance, if it is tall and broad. Okay, if it is tall or if it is tall as well as broad, so that indicates that person was suffering from the AMI, that is acute myocardial infarctions. Okay, that denotes if it is a tall or broad. Okay, so that indicates that person was suffering from the AMI or acute myocardial infarction. So with the help of the TVO, we can diagnose the AMI or acute myocardial infarction. Or if it is small and flattened, okay, it is small and flattened. So that indicates person was suffering from the myocardial infarction or anxiety. There is a fear. Fear is known as the anxiety, that person having the higher, always the fear life. So that is known as the anxiety. Or that person should be old age. So without the knowledge of age, with the help of ECG, we can diagnose it. Whether it is related to the adult or it is related to the old age people. With the help of only TVO. So where the TVO is a small and it should be the flattened. So that denotes that person can suffer the myocardial infarction or that person is living the anxiety or that person belongs to old age or left ventricular hypertrophy and pericarditis. Okay, so left ventricular hypertrophy, that word denoted. So with the help of the TVOs and the left ventricle function, it should be the important. Okay, if it is hypertrophy, if it is swell, means the ventricles are contracted that need to more blood pressure because they are swelling. The swelling part of the ventricles, it will be required the more pressure. So due to that, the blood pressure can be exceed that regarding systolic more than 180 mmHg. But normal is a only 120. Due to left ventricular hypertrophy, then the pressure is exceed because the ventricles are not properly contract in the normal pressure. So due to automatically in the defense mechanism to fulfill the demand of the organ, automatically the pressure was exceeded due to left ventricular hypertrophy. So that was denoted or diagnosis. So with the help of the TVOs, if the person having blood pressure more than 80, then you can go for the ECG. In the ECG, if the TVOs is small and flattened, small hai or flat hua hai. Okay, so that denotes that candidate was suffering from the left ventricular hypertrophy. So only the antihypertensive drug classical like a propranolol, atenolol, they are not suitable for to control that hypertension along with hypertrophy. Where the need to add the ACE inhibitors. So these are category of drugs. Example is a certain losartan is there. Okay. So these are the ACE inhibitors. So that drug is required along with propranolol or atenolol to control the blood pressure and to treat the left ventricular hypertrophy. So that's why ECG is helpful for to give the therapy. If only blood pressure is elevated, then T waves are normal. That indicates only sufficient propranolol, atenolol, metoprolol is sufficient, or amlodipine is sufficient to treat the disorder. If it is the flattened, that denotes maybe left ventricular hypertrophy. So after that, the doctor, they can confirm through a droplet test, cardiac droplet test, 2D, 3D. Okay, from 2D, 3D, they can denote heart is well or not, or what is the capacity of left ventricle with the help of 2D or 3D of the heart. That was known as droplet test or 2D test or 3D test. They were, they can confirm left ventricular hypertrophy is problem or not. If it is not, then simple classical medication they are used for the control of the hypertension. If it is swelled from the 3D also or 2D also, droplet, cardiac droplet is also, then they can add the drug AC inhibitors. Then the therapy can be achieved successfully. So next one, so regarding the PR interval, okay, it can, the distance between P and R wave is 0.1 to 0.2 second. It means there is 5 small square. Okay, the traveling, a distance between P and R wave is a, that is a, but the 0.1 to 0.2 second. That is a 3 to 5 small square. Okay, so with the help of PR interval, we can find out the various conditions of the heart. That is, if it is prolonged, if it is more than crosses 5 small square, so that denotes first heart block, or that is first degree heart block or bradycardia. If it is more than 5 small square traveling or distance of PR interval, that denotes the person was suffering with bradycardia, that is decrease the heart rate more than normal, that was known as bradycardia, or first degree heart block. If it is shortened, if it is less than 3 small square, but normally is 3 to 5 small square, if it is less than 3 small square distance between P and R interval, so that indicate the person was suffering from the tachycardia or glycogen storage disease. So like that, with the help of PR interval, we can note down the first degree heart block or tachycardia, bradycardia or glycogen storage disease. So next one is the, so regarding the QT interval, distance between Q waves and T waves, so that was 0.4 to 0.42 second. It means that is 0.1 is equal to 2.5 small square. Here there is 0.4 is there. That's why it can taken the 10 small square distance regarding the different distance between the QT. So that was take the 10 small square. Okay, if it is more than 10 small square, it can denote myocardial infarction, myocarditis, hypokalemia or hypothyroidism. If it is shortened less than this 10 small square, that it denotes the person was suffering from the hyperkalemia, calcemia, that is the calcium in the blood will be more, so where the distance between QT interval decreases. And if the deficiency of calcium is there, or person suffering from hypothyroidism or myocardial infarctions or myocarditis, so where the QT interval is the prolonged more than the 0.4 seconds. So that was read from the ECG itself. So next one is the interpretations of heart rhythm, how the heart can work properly or not, what beats properly or not. So that was readed with the help of the, by measuring the distance between RR and S view. The distance between 2R view or 2S view. So that was helpful for to note down the heart rhythm. If the distance between RR interval is uniform throughout the ECG for 1 minute, if it is uniformly run on the ECG, that indicates the heartbeat should be the regular. If sometime that should be the 15 small square, and next time it should be 20, and next time it was 10, like that, the distance between RR waves, that is the varies, okay, our variable is there. So that denotes our heart rhythm is irregular. If every because so this graph consists of number of R views for 1 minute. Because in 1 minute we having around 72 bits. It means it will be minimum, it can record 72 ECGs. Okay. Then note down the distance between R view. It is the regular fashion, uniform. That indicates our rhythm is regular. If it is abnormal, that indicates our rhythm is the irregular. So that's why the heart rhythm is also note down. So with the help of the ECG. So next one is the, so regarding the calculations of heart rate. Okay, stethoscope is beneficial. Our pulse rate is also helpful for to note down the heart rate. But still, with the help of ECG, we also record the, calculate the heart rate. Simple, by using the following these two formula. That is the heart rate, okay? That is the divided by, that is the, is equal to 300 divided by number of large square between RR. So here the between the RR, the number of large square is 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 4.1. Okay, if anyone students having the calculator with you means you can divide. There is a 300 divided by 4.1 small square. Then you can got the heart rate around 70 to 80. Because it is normal ECG. And it can cross this. It can distance between the RR wave is, that is a 1 large square, 2, 3, 4. Then there is a 4.1 or 4.2. Okay, you can divide 300 divided by 4.2 large square. Then can you got the exact heart rate. Or another formula is 1500 divided by number of small square between RR. So your number of square is here 4, 4, 4, 4 and 1. That is 4 into 4, 16. That is the 17. You can divide 1500 divided by. Okay, so that can divide by 1500 divided by 17. Then you can got the heart rate. So like that, with the help of ECG, we also record the heart rate.